Assalamu alaikum dear students, hope you are still in good health. Let's start with our session 2. In our session 2, I'm going to explain the term relief map and then I'm going to explain the relief map of Pakistan. Let's start with the explanation of relief map. The relief map shows the height of the land above the sea level by using different colors. On page number 3, we have relief map of subcontinent. If you look at this map, this is a very colorful map and different colors are showing different height of land above the sea level. You can easily read this map by using the key given at the right side of the map. If you look at this key carefully, then you can see different shades of blue color. These different shades of blue color are showing different depth of sea, whereas different colors going upward are showing different heights of land above the sea level. Now students, move to page number 4. This is the relief map of Pakistan. Now I'm going to explain this map for you. There are two keys with this map. The first key is explaining the directions north, south, east and west, and another key is explaining the different heights of land by using different colors. Let's start with the explanation of this map. These are the highest areas of Pakistan, and the color of these areas are purple. If you look at this key, the purple color is showing the height of 5000 meter. It means these areas of the Pakistan are 5000 meter high from the sea level. The white color is showing that these areas of the Pakistan are always covered with snow throughout the year. In the Pakistan, there are also many deserts, and the deserts are shown through green colors with brown dots in it. In fact, only about 1/3 of the Pakistan is suitable for farming, and most of that needs irrigation. Most of the north and west of the Pakistan consist of high mountains. Means the high mountains are showing in orange color, and the height which is showing by the orange color is 2000 meter high. There are also lower but dry mountain ranges in the west and southwest of Balochistan, and there are only sheltered valleys over there, and these valleys are famous for producing apples, grapes, oranges and apricots, extra. The western areas of the Pakistan are fairly highlands. There are no high mountains over there. They are just fairly highlands, and which gets very little rainfall. And these lands are not good for crop farming. And the people are keeping herds of sheep and goats. And in the drier season, they have to travel long distance to find food for the animals. On page number 5. We're discussing about the different deserts of the Pakistan. In the south of Sindh and Balochistan, there are deserts, and these deserts are Thar and Thal. The Thar deserts are extend far into the India, whereas Thal desert exists in the Indus Valley. In the Pakistan, we have greatest mountain ranges such as Himalayas, Karakoram and Hindu Kush. One of the highest peak is the mountain Everest, which exists in Nepal. It is 8848 meters high, and the most agriculture areas of Pakistan are found in Indus Valley. Almost 3/4 of the population of the country live in the provinces of Punjab. According to the figure of 2006, 55% of the population of the Pakistan is living in the province of Punjab, whereas 30% of the population are living in the Sindh. Almost 80% of the region is irrigated by a well-developed canal system that uses water from the Indus rivers. And this area has always been very fertile, producing the bulk of agriculture produced in Pakistan. With this, I'm going to finish my lecture. Stay safe at home. Thank you so much.